Good morning, everybody. Today we are going to study autopsy. What is an autopsy? Autopsy is nothing but seeing oneself, that is examination of same person externally and internally with additional investigative procedures. That is the procedure which is called as autopsy. Autopsy is variably called as postmortem, sometimes necropsy or thanatoscopy. Scopy is the study, and postmortem, post is after, and mortem is the death. So study of the dead body after death. So seeing oneself, that is making personal inspection, is an autopsy. To explain more, dissection of the dead body to determine a thorough observations and establish the nature of disease or cause of death. So to define autopsy as detailed scrutiny of both external surfaces and the internal surfaces or internal contents of dead body after opening the cavities, including further examination required such as histology, the biochemistry and toxicology of collected material. The autopsy is done to study the careful dissection of the body of the deceased to investigate the cause of death, to observe the changes in the various organs and proper clinico-pathological correlation. Usually, pathologists, clinicians and medical students, both undergraduates as well as the postgraduate students, can learn lot about the diseases from the autopsy. And this explains the Greek statement, Moris vivos docent, that it dead teaches the living persons. There are two terms which are loosely used, but commonly they are used: autopsy as well as post-mortem examination, PME, post-mortem examination. PME is a broader term. This is my short form, is not commonly used, is not an universally accepted short form, is a broader term which means all the examinations conducted or performed after death, and includes the examination of the body at the scene or the place of death and as well as at the autopsy room. In our country, the autopsy is postmortem or autopsy. Autopsy is done by the police. Postmortem is done by the police, whereas the autopsy is conducted by the doctors. The nearest civil surgeon or the qualified medical man appointed by on behalf of state government. Coming to the brief historical aspect of autopsy, the medico-legal autopsy was first time introduced in 1302 AD in Italy. The procedure was carried out by the physicians and surgeons. Antonio Benivenien is regarded as the father of pathological anatomy, and Morgagni in the 17th century laid the foundation of autopsy. Later on, various authors have carried out functions and gave their opinions. One of them is the Karl Rokitansky, who conducted nearly 30,000 autopsies and observed the deceased persons. Briefly, we have given the idea about the autopsy. The detailed indications for the autopsy are: number one, clinically uncertain cause of death. Number two, unexplained or unexpected death. Number three, unknown or unanticipated medical complications. Number four, death during or after any surgical, medical or dental diagnostic procedure. Number five, high risk infections or contagious diseases, obstetric and pediatric deaths. Number six, neonatal and pediatric death. Number seven, known or suspected environmental or occupational hazards. Number eight, patients participated in the clinical trials. Number nine, apparently natural or natural death subject to waived by the forensic medical jurisdiction. That means which are not done by the forensic department, those can be done in the medical field. Help to relieve the concern and provide the reassurance to the family or the public. So these are the indications for autopsy. There are different types of autopsies. Number one, clinical, pathological, medical or hospital autopsy. Number two, medico-legal autopsy. Now about this, much of the things we learn during the lectures on forensic medicine. Anatomical or academic autopsy. Verbal or psychological autopsy. Then endoscopic autopsy. And last is virtual autopsy. Now we will see in short about each of them. So the clinical, pathological, medical and hospital autopsy is carried out on the patient who dies in a hospital during the course of treatment and performed with the consent of next of the kin of the deceased person. The objectives of such autopsies are: determine the exact cause of death that could not be ascertained before death. Number two, confirm or establish the clinical diagnosis made before the death needs to be confirmed. Number three, to evaluate the effect of drug therapy given during life. Number four, extent of disease is to be ascertained. Number five, to determine the disease causing death, that is to confirm the clinical diagnosis that remained unclear prior to the patient's death. Number six, to educate the medical students and doctors and for medical research purpose. And number seven, to allow removal of certain organs or the tissues for transplantation purposes. These autopsies are performed by the pathologist with the consent of relatives. Number two, medico-legal autopsy or forensic autopsy. Much you will learn in forensic department, but still in brief we will see. Essential examination of the dead body to rule out or to establish the course, the manner and any foul play in the death and is performed only on requisition of legal authority responsible for investigation of sudden, suspicious, violent or unnatural death. The legal authority is usually police officer and not below the rank of sub-inspector or magistrate. Number 3 is anatomical autopsy performed to study the normal structure of the human body. Mostly it is done on the unclaimed dead bodies. The anatomist and the medical students perform this autopsy. Number 4, psychological autopsy performed in alleged cases of suicide to know about the mental health or mental status of the deceased at the time of death, the background of person, habits, mental status, personality and the character of the deceased and relations with others, that is the source of collection of information. The sources are family members, friends, teachers, professional colleagues, physicians and not the police. Number 5 is the endoscopic autopsies and number 6 is the virtual autopsy. The PM examination, that is postmortem examination, without compromising the integrity of the body, even without collection of any sample. Due to some of the reasons or the diseases, the autopsy is not possible, then by help of X-ray, ultrasound, CT scan, MRI can detect the cause of death, that is virtual autopsy. So, this is to show you the autopsy table and the autopsy room. Again, the table, autopsy table, where the body is kept and autopsy is done. These are the basins and the instruments which are kept on the table, side table it is. Most important is the identification of the body. Some tags are labeled on the body and you have to identify the body with these tags and you have to carry out the autopsy on the same body. These are the just storage of the dead bodies. So coming to the proper autopsy. When we receive the body for an autopsy and a request from the higher authorities, then when we enter the autopsy room, we have to do the external examination of the body. We have to incise with various types of incisions which we take and then we have to examine the internal organs of the body. So the external examination of the body. General condition as regards to height, weight, build, nutritional status, condition of the skin, hair, rigor mortis, postmortem sampling and decomposition areas that you have to see. Then clothing should be listed and examined with regards to its nature, condition, tears, cuts, any holes, loss of buttons, disarrangement, all these have to be noted. Each item is removed from the body. Remove the clothes carefully without tearing. If they can't be removed intact, they should cut along the seams and not in haphazard way. Stains like blood, seminal fluid, grease, etc. should be noted. In all the cases of sexual assault, vaginal and anal swabs are taken. Note the presence of stains on the skin from the blood, mud or vomit and feces. Note the presence of signs of any disease. Coming to the examination of face, should be examined for frothy fluid at the mouth and nose, the cyanosis, pallor, petechial hemorrhages, etc. Examination of the eyes should be examined for condition of eyelids, conjunctiva, color of the sclera, pupils, contact lenses, petechiae and periorbital tissue for extravasation of blood. Examination of the neck must be examined for bruises, fingernails, abrasions, ligature marks or any other abnormality. The thyroid, size and nodularity, lymph nodes, the cervical, axillary and inguinal lymph nodes, thorax, symmetry and general outline of the thorax, breast if it is a female patient or size and masses, abdominal, presence or absence of distension or retraction, striae gravidum, back for bed sores, spinal deformity and external genitalia for general development, edema, local infection, position of the testis, etc. The natural orifices, if that is mouth, nostrils, ear, vaginal, anal canals, etc. should be examined for the injuries, the foreign matters, blood, etc. Hands should be examined for the injuries, the defense wounds, the electric marks. If clenched, to open hand completely, flexor tendons cut at the wrist. Look for the needle puncture marks in the arms, buttocks, etc. The external injuries such as abrasions, bruises, lacerations, burns, etc. should be examined systematically with full of details to include the exact site, the length, the breadth, the direction, the position, the margins, the base and the extent. And lastly, to determine whether caused before or after death or their time of infliction. This is the list of investigations, this is the list of instruments which are used in the autopsy room. Surgical blade, knife, scissors, probes, dissecting forceps, cartilage and rib cutters, chisels and hammer, surgical hand gloves, sewing material, preservatives, labeling and sealing material, bone forceps, skull elevator, brain knife, scalp knife, measuring jar, weighing machine, magnifying lens and steel trays. There are different methods by which the autopsies are done. One is Virchow's method. The second is Rokitansky's method, the third is Letilli's method and fourth is Gonds method. Primary skin incisions to open the body after examination of external examination, we have to open the body with different types of incisions. One is eye-shaped incision, extending from the chin, that is symphysis menti, straight down to the symphysis pubis, avoiding the umbilicus because the dense fibrous tissue is difficult to penetrate with the needle when the body is stitched after autopsy. Number two, Y-shaped incision, starting from the symphysis pubis, to the GP sternum and then towards the acromion process of clavicles and extend down below the breast up to the xiphoid process on both the sides. The Y-shaped incision is desirable in those cases where it's customary to keep the dressed body for viewing sometimes after death, used extensively in the Western countries. Modified Y-shaped incision. Incision from the suprasternal notch to symphysis pubis in the midline that extend the incision from the suprasternal notch up to the center of clavicle on both sides, passes upwards over the neck behind the ear. Used when the detailed study of neck organs is required, that is hanging and strangulations. The midline abdominal incision, that is after cutting the diaphragm, the thoracic organs can be removed. Inverted Y-shaped incision sometimes is used. Then coronal bitemporal incisions for removal of brain and posterior midline incision for removal of spinal cord. These are various types of incisions. Then methods. Various methods which we have seen, Virchow's method, Gons method, Lutty's method. So first is Virchow's method. Rudolf Virchow, the father of pathology, has given this method. Organs are removed separately one by one and studied individually. Organs are removed separately one by one and studied individually. The cranial, thoracic, abdominal cavity and cervical region. All these organs are removed one by one and then their study is done. It is quick and suitable for beginners, but disadvantage is causes loss of continuity and the difficult to evaluate the interrelationship of the organs. Number two is Rokitansky's method. Karl Rokitansky, the German pathologist, has advocated this type of method. In situ dissection of the part combined with en bloc removal of organs. Advantages is infected bodies considered good in children. So this is advantage of Rokitansky's method. That is, infected bodies can be dissected and en bloc organs can be removed, and it is considered good in the children also, but difficult to perform. That is the disadvantage. Letelieu's method by Maurice Letelieu, a French pathologist, commonly used and consists of en bloc removal of cervical, thoracic, abdominal and pelvic organs. Dissection is later. Dissection of each individual organ is done later. All the organs removed en masse and dissected as organ block. Advantages are organs, the interrelationship are preserved and body can be handed over very quickly. Disadvantages, organs are difficult to handle. Then Gons method, advocated by Gons, an Austrian pathologist. Here en bloc method is used. Cervical, thoracic, abdominal, pelvic organs are removed in three blocks. Neural system is removed as another block. Advantage is excellent preservation of the organs and handling of the organs is easier. Disadvantage is interrelationship is difficult to study if the disease is extending to all the blocks, means all the systems. So before proceeding to the autopsy or postmortem, It is necessary to have request form filled by the clinician and should contain the written autopsy permission from an appropriate relative or deceased of person responsible for burial. The brief relevant clinical and laboratory data and the clinical diagnosis should be provided by the clinicians. The pathologist should also note type of incision and the extent of autopsy and identification of the body before starting autopsy. Pediatric autopsy needs the special care to focus attention on the congenital malformations and peculiar lesions like hyaline membrane disease, obstructive pathology in the mouth, larynx, trachea, bronchi, patency of the anal canal and bile ducts and umbilical vessels, spine and thymus. The various investigative procedures to sum up. Methods used in the autopsy are the gross examination, the microscopic or histopathological examination, the microbiologic study, the blood vegetations, the fluid, etc., electron microscopy if needed, chromosomal study from the bone marrow, blood, gonads and thymus, biochemical investigations, radiological investigations, angiography, autoradiography and vinyl cast. So for today this much is the sufficient. So tomorrow we will see the specific autopsies. We will study nearly 5 autopsies tomorrow in tomorrow's lecture. Thank you. Thank you.